one of the most basic questions I get is, you know, what fiber stripper should I use? It's personal preference, really. This one happens to be the Ripley stripper. You can see this one I've had for quite a long time. And there's many of them out there. I like the one that has the three separate holes to handle any jacket that you have on a simplex cable. If you look here, this top hole on the Ripley unit here, it cuts your 3 mil jacket. One of the things guys do, I know these seem fairly basic, but I think they can help. One of the things guys will do when they go to strip is they squeeze and pull, right? Probably okay, but not the best idea. One of the things that can happen is as you pull a blade past the fiber, we can do some damage, and we might not even see it. If we're doing connectors, we might not see it until we're already finished. We might have damaged it down inside the fiber here under the jackets. If you've ever seen a pull rope or a pull string in a multi-fiber cable, what you're supposed to do, if you're doing this, you know, 100% correctly, is when you open that jacket and expose that pull rope, peel that jacket back, and then any area that a blade had touched, you're supposed to cut, and anything you're using has to be just pull rope exposed. So one of the issues I have with this, like I said before, was just cutting and pulling. A little minor change here would be to squeeze. Sometimes you want to rock forward and backwards. Never twist, though. And I like to set the tool down and just use my hands to do the final cut of this jacket. That's going to keep us from having a blade go across. We can ding up this Kevlar and, like I said, damage the fiber. So I already did that back here, and I'm going to expose this fiber. So we saw this first hole, did the 3 mil jacketing. I'm going to move this fiber away. Now we have our 900. One of the things, if you're doing connectorization by hand or splicing, when we strip your 900, this tight buffer here, and again, there's different versions. Corning has what they call a TB2. It's a loose tight buffer. So if I clip it down here, I can actually pull it. Our company, TLC, wonderful company, uses all Corning fiber, but we do a tight buffer, a real tight buffer, so you have to strip it in small lengths. You can see if we try to pull off a larger length, breaks the fiber because this buffer is extruded directly to the bare glass. One of the big holdups or the frustrations of stripping is guys try to strip it in one pull. You should take lots of little strips, right? So short little pulls on the, get rid of that excess fiber or jacket there, and it's a much better strip. So this middle hole here removes the 900. But back to the connectorization of the splicing, we always want a nice flat cut on the 900. And you'll see if we look on the camera, when we squeeze, we're gonna do that flat cut again. You can see that the fiber on this side angles down, but we're gonna pull in this direction. You're kind of pulling against the grain. See how that's down at a quite a slope? And you can break your fibers, but we still want that flat cut. So how do we get the best of both worlds? Very basic, very, very basic, is when I cut to make it flat, before I do the strip, angle the tool before we strip. You're gonna get a lot less breakage and a higher efficiency with your stripping. Some of you don't realize, but there is an acrylic 250 micron coating. That's for the third hole here. When you're splicing, if you don't get this off, the cleaver won't cut, you won't be able to splice. So again, that third hole, we don't need to do small strips, we can just take it off in one pull. And you'll see the material left behind. What I like to do is blow that out of there. Now, some people say, you know, my stool's breaking on the 900 or the 250. One of the little tricks that I do is, and eventually your tool will wear out, but you know, I've got this stripper here has probably been with me 20 years, give or take. But some people will say, you know, my tool isn't stripping or it's cutting. So one of the little tricks I do is I pull this little latch out here, open this up a little bit farther. Let me get this a little bit farther for you. You can see it hasn't been open in a long time. And this allows this tool to open larger. And we get debris inside these jaws or epoxies, and that'll cause it to just be a little bit smaller and do our breaks. So what I like to do, not rough, just take my little box cutter blade and just run it through the groove to get any materials that were caught up in there. Close the latch back, and we've made this tool last longer for us. And again, there's a tons of different tools. This one here, the good folks at Ripley, we sell. it's a different type of a tool, but the same thing. You can see there's different on the ends here, different jacket sizes. You can see this is for the 900 and the 250. And with this one, I'll do my little fiber breaking trick. We just set it into the required length, squeeze, and pull the fiber, and there we go. And if we want to do the 250, we go into that hole and do the same thing. One thing you'll notice too is when you have a newer strip tool, a lot of times when you're stripping the 900, the 250 will come off and you won't even see a 250 coating. It's because the tool is pretty fresh. You'll notice this one didn't do it. I've had this a while, so you would have to go to that third hole. But it's a quick overview of stripping tools. There's a ton of them out there. It's all personal preference. Some have ergonomic handles, you know, to save our hands, I guess, if we're doing lots of stripping. But again, it's personal preference, and I never would recommend one over the other. I will say the Ripley tool has been excellent. But thanks again.